Hi, you are watching module 1 videos. In module 2, we have around 120 videos. We teach Java with Selenium in real time. So end-to-end Java will be there and end-to-end Selenium will be there in complete real time. We provide classroom training as well as online training. So complete Java and Selenium will be there in real time. Hi, welcome to RAMESHSOFT video tutorials. In this video tutorial, we will talk about the most happening interview question is the difference between final and static. Now, so final is a keyword which is applicable for variables, methods and classes, that is outer classes as well, inner classes as well, but not for interfaces, right? Now, so now see here, final is a keyword which is applicable for what? Variables, comma, methods, comma, inner classes as well as outer classes, but not for interfaces. Whereas static is a keyword which is applicable for variables, methods and for inner classes, but not for outer classes, and but not for outer interfaces, but it is for what? Inner interfaces, right? Yes. Now, so whenever we declare a variable as a final, we cannot perform reassignment of that variable. If we try to perform reassignment of that variable, we will get compile time error. Whenever we declare a methods as a final, overriding of that methods in the child class is not possible. Right. Even if you want, we can declare inner classes and outer classes as a what? Final. So whenever we are declaring classes as a final, inheritance is not become possible. If we declare a class as a final, if we try to extend that class, we will get compile time error. Now, static is a keyword which is applicable for variables. So when the value of a variable is not going to be changes object to object, then declare such kind of variables as what? Static variables. And for all static variables, static methods, for all those things, only a single copy is going to be shared when we are creating the object. Even we can declare a method as a static. Whenever we declare a method as a static, without creating object, we can access that methods through a class. Even if you want, we can define inner class as a static but not outer class. Even we can define a inner interface as a static but not outer interface as static. In my previous videos, I explained inner class and inner interfaces mechanisms with static both as well as non-static. Just watch my videos, okay? There you'll get the complete clarity. Yes. Clear? Yes. Now see here. So let's start with the first term, final. Final. Now see here. Let me write one example. First we'll go through on final. Now I'm writing new class. Now I'm taking final test. Final test. Now see here. Now I'm taking here one variable final. I'm declaring final variable int a is equal to 900. Now let me take one method public void. I'm taking displays one method. Now inside this method, now see what I'm doing. I'm trying to change the value of a is equal to 8000. Right? So I'm trying to reassignment that of variable, right? So as we know that whenever we declare a variable as a final, can we perform reassignment of that variable? We cannot perform reassignment of that variable. If we try to perform reassignment of that variable, we will get what now? Compile time error. See here what I'm getting. So remove final modifier of a or not? Yes, let me remove this. Now is it valid? Yes, now it is valid. That is, whenever we declare a variable as a final, can we perform reassignment of that variable? We cannot perform reassignment of that variable. If we try to perform reassignment of that variable, we will get what? Compile time error. Clear? Yes. And final versus variables we done. That is, whenever we declare the variable as a final, we cannot perform reassignment of that variable. Right. Now see here what I'm doing. Now, this is my class. I'm taking my final test is my class. Inside this class, I'm having a method called display. So we can declare methods as what? Final. So whenever we declare a method as a final, we cannot perform overriding of that method in the child class. If we try to do, we will get what? Compile time error. Now see here what I'm doing. Class test extends now final test. Now this author here. Now what I'm doing? Let me try to override this method. Now see here what I'm doing. I am trying to override this method in the child class. So we will get a compile time error. Because this method is what method there? Final method, right? See here, remove final modifier of what? Final test. Because final test is of what class? And in this class, I am having a method called display of type is what? Final, right? Now let me remove this final. Now see here, any problem? No problem at all. That is, the moment we declare the method as a final, whenever we declare a method as a final, can we perform overriding in the child class? It is not possible. If we try to do overriding, we will get what? Compile time error. Clear? Yes. Now third one, we can apply final for what? Classes as well. Now see here, whenever I am declaring a class as a final, we cannot perform what? Inheritance. If we try to perform inheritance, we will get what? Compile time error. Now see here, I am getting compile time error. See here, saying that what is that? Remove what? Final modifier. Clear? Yes. Even this final modifier is applicable for inner classes as well, right? So I am declaring a class called test2 test. Now close it. Now see here. Now this is what my outer class, this is what my inner class. So can we declare inner class as a final? Yes, no problem at all. We can declare inner class as a final, we can declare what? Outer class as a final. So whenever we declare classes as a final, we cannot perform inheritance of that classes. That is, we cannot perform extends. Inheritance is not possible when we declare the classes as a final. Clear? So this is about what? Final. Now static is a keyword which is applicable for variables, methods and what? Inner classes and inner interfaces, right? Now see here, so for final variables we cannot perform reassignment, but for static variables we can perform what? Reassignment. No problem at all. For static variables we can happily perform reassignment of that variables. And whenever we declare a method as a final, we cannot override in the child class. In the same way, whenever we declare a method as a static, in the child class, we cannot perform overriding. If we try to perform overriding, we will get what? Compile time error. Clear? Yes. If you want to access without creation of object, if you want to access inner class data, then declare inner class as a what? Static. Inside interface, we can declare another interfaces, that is inner interfaces. Whether we declare or not, every inner interface by default is become what? Static. So if you don't know about inner class and inner interfaces, just watch my previous videos as they're in module 1, right? Now just observe here what I'm doing. I'm taking one variable of type static. Now see here, I'm changing the static variable of type to what? 800 or not? Am I getting any issues? No issues at all. Clear? Yes. Am I getting any compile time error? No compile time error. Happily we can run the what? This method. Now I'm printing SYSO of. Now let me print that value. Now I'm printing this here. Right? Now see here. Create object. Let me take the main method. Now I'm taking the main method. Create object of it. Test is equal to new final test. Now see here what I'm doing. Now test dot display method. Happily we can call it. And see here what is output we are going to get. Right click, run as Java application. Now which test you want on it? Final test, right? Right click, okay. Now see here what is output I'm getting? 8000 or not? Yes. So we can change the values? Yes. Right? Yes. But final variables we cannot change it. But if you want, we can change the static variables. Now, so whenever we declare a method as a final, we cannot override in the child class. In the same way, whenever we declare a method as a final, in the child class, we cannot override that what? Static methods. Otherwise, we'll get what? Compile time error. See here. I am declaring this display method as a what? Static. So in the child class, when I am trying to perform overriding, So here I am getting what? Compile time error or not? Yes. Clear? And even if we want, we can declare inner class as a what? Static. Now see, here I am taking class test, class test. Now can we declare outer class as a static? We should not declare outer class as a static, but we can declare inner classes as a what? Static. No problem at all, right? And even the same way, if we want, we can declare inner interface as a what? Static, but not outer interface as a static. Now see here, I am taking interface A inside this interface. I am taking one more interface called B, right? Now see here, whether we declare or not, every inner interface is by default is become what? Static. I mean, this A interface is called what? Outer interface. This B interface is called what? Inner interface. So in Java, every inner interface by default is become what? Static. Now see here whether we declare or not. Static. Now see here, no problem at all. That is, static is a keyword which is applicable for variables, methods, which is applicable for inner classes, and which is applicable for inner interfaces. So this is the major difference between final and static, the most happening interview question for both Java developers as well as Selenium automation developers. Thanks for watching the videos. Have a good day. Please subscribe the videos. Thank you so much.